And that's Ophelia, my assistant, who is very camera shy. We're here for the Bailey Minute. And I have a few finds that I wanted to share with you all. First one's a contemporary piece. It's a wonderful, very nice, wide cut-out bangle bracelet, like etched designs. I think it's getting approval from my assistant. That's never a bad sign. Love it. Something that I'm definitely going to be able to turn over quickly at the market. It's just wonderful to accessorize a lot of the clothing and things that I'm finding. It doesn't go with the outfit I've got on, but it's a smashing piece. Actually, the original tag was on it. It came from Macy's, and it was made in India, I believe. Yeah. I was showing everybody this bracelet before, and it made me think about all of my love of bracelets. I've got a real love of bracelets. It's funny because I make jewelry, and I make a few bracelets, but mainly I make necklaces. So I think it's funny how many bracelets I tend to buy. I've been collecting green and orange and yellow Bakelite. And Bakelite-like bangles for a while now. And as soon as I get enough, I'll probably end up selling them. Because they look so nice displayed together. I don't know if you can pick up. These are just such fabulous. There's definitely one here I'd love to share, but I know you won't be able to see it on the camera. And if anybody out there knows anything more about this than me, I haven't tested it for Bakelite, but this one is amazing. It's got it's a marble effect, like a lot of the Bakelite, and kind of in the, I'm looking at it now, it's almost like it's, I don't know if it's carved or what, but there is a picture of a little Asian woman in the side of it. And then there's one that's super detailed, and then there's some characters, and I've got to ask some friends of mine to find out what, but it looks like it could be either Japanese or, I don't know, but it's really unique, and I've never seen anything like it, and I got it from a good friend of mine at the market who gave me a wonderful price on it, so that was kind of an exciting find. I'll never part with that because it's special in that I got the great bargain, and I don't know, when somebody does that, extends themselves like that, I usually hold on to the piece at least for quite a while. So, wonderful collection, and I'm adding to it. I just bought these four today, so that I did get some more things from my find, my haul to show you today. Four different colored kind of marbly smaller bangles. They look really good stacked. Okay, so that was, and then I got super excited about them all, and I decided to, that's going to be a fun display. I may even take them to this big show that I'm going to be doing in June because it looks so wonderful. But I want to get premium prices. All right, we'll set that aside. Let's move on to some of the clothes. I haven't even really pulled them out and shaken them out yet, and I have some of it I got earlier today. I can't even remember what I got, so it's going to be really a fun haul, I think. Hopefully we can do this in one episode because, okay, so you see me, I'm wearing a skirt from a previous haul. It's the one that's made with tinsel. I love the way it sounds when I walk today. It's kind of a whoosh, whoosh, whoosh sound, and it's so comfortable, and it skims. It's not tight. You don't have to see all those bits and parts that you don't want to be showing everybody every, not that I have any of that, of course, but I love the way it hangs, and I know that it'll wash up really nice and easy in cold water, so that's also a bonus. There's a bit of a string I might have to repair there. So funnily enough, in that same vein, I found another one today. And this one's even, this is great because it's a really small size. This is going to be super cute. Kind of prairie style a little bit, but I love it with the, one second, my personal favorite, the concho belt. I think you'll be seeing this. You've seen it before, and you'll see it many, many more times, won't you? But it's a great look. Also, I have that other belt here still. I haven't put anything away. It's quite a mess in the house. I'm going to be doing an episode on editing, because clearly my entryway table is in need of an editing, of an edit. I've been collecting things and thinking about this show that I'm doing and the theme, and it's very Gypsy Caravan, and I think this is kind of accumulating that look. But here, back to my, see how cute that belt will be with this skirt? Okay. Let's just stay with skirts first. Oh my gosh, that's not a skirt. The next skirt I got is real kind of 70s rap style. I paid plenty for these. I didn't think I liked the prices too much. $6.50. But I think 20 is also a fair price to ask, styled right. It's just a really cute. The weirdest thing, I was trying things on and I was really lazy and I didn't want to like go in the dressing room and do the whole thing. I just needed to get an idea of sizing. So I went ahead and wrapped this on. Whoops. I like it on the side, actually. It's hard to do this without a mirror, so I'm just kind of hoping that my cameraman can give me his. So what I liked, this one's really tiny, but look how cute it is to layer over another skirt. You do that and you, well, I don't know, it's kind of a good gypsy look, and that's kind of the thing that I'm going for right now. So anyway, it's got a really sweet little print that really harkens back to my youth. Makes me think of really cute little dresses that my mom used to make me. She used to make dresses for me and for my little doll, and they matched. So cute. All right. Another skirt that I just want to eat it. It's so cute. It's so, like, Guatemala, Peruvian. I don't even know how it goes on. I don't know if this is the front. No. That's the back, so it's kind of like... wonderful. Super cute. The back is the best. I'm trying to see what it looks like in front. I don't think it's doing me any big, huge favors. I'm definitely going to be able to sell this, though. A few strings I need to trim off. I wonder if it might look cute on the side, too. I really like this layering effect. It's really working for me. Okay, I think that... oh, one more skirt. This one's going to be, well, a little bit harder to see maybe on camera. This is kind of like a petticoat style, but so cute with like colorful, like little short tap panty style underneath. And it's such a cute, this is so cute, kind of rockabilly a little bit. Also cinched in, kind of wear it high, cinch it in. Maybe even a cute little bodysuit with it. I love this one. It's all lace. It's going to be hard to part with this one. I'm not sure if I will. This is really, I don't know how good I am at this business. So that one was $6.50 also. It's just great. It's got a little life of its own. A lot of movement. Okay, same store. I got, this is not, this is contemporary. But it's a really good fitting and I love linen, so that's, and it's nice and small. So that's possibly for me or, and then this is big, but it's really cute on, even on me it was not too bad. It's kind of funny, normally these kinds of sleeves, I'm not so into it, but I like the kind of artist painter smock look to it. I think it almost could work. Once again, layered, if you do it right. It's a lot of sleeve, admittedly, but super cute because it's a really good fabric. Again, it's linen, and so are we having lighting issues by any chance? So I have this light. This is probably a good time to talk about it. It's magic. And it, at the most inopportune times, it'll like go off and on. It's a three-way, but it's not a three-way bolt. There's some weird mechanism in there, but we don't have it really working right, so it's almost like it's shorting, but it's not. But when I move the table, it's like a ghost. Let's see, Ophie loves this. My little assistant here, Ophelia, she's now nesting in the clothes. I think that's her favorite part. Oh, I'm super excited about this dress. Oh. Now this is so cute. The waist is lost its mojo. It was elastic and it used to cinch in better, so it's not as big as it looks because it's only a size 4. And I'm going to try that on and we'll definitely do an episode where I show you how to style some of these things. I think this dress might, once again, I'm not sure I can sell it, but I have to. This is the business. Okay. All of you know that I'm really into boho gypsy. The last couple items I'm going to show you. Oh, they're nothing like out of this world, but they're definitely going to be cute on. Little halter style dress, very boho hippie. It's all about how you style it. I've been noticing that my fabulous bag of wonderful stones has been working with everything I wear. The story behind that is wonderful because I was having an interesting day at the market. Some people took something out of my booth and I had to hunt them down and, you know, had that kind of situation, and these guys that were selling across from me had these wonderful magical rocks, and they were wonderful to me, and they made me the special bag. I mean, they were selling these, of course, but they're just energy and everything, just really made the day wonderful despite some small setbacks. Okay, this is the other kind of a hippie style little tunic thing. I think this will be really cute with jeans again. Once again, I'll style it. Don't worry. You can look forward to that at the next episode. I always want to call them installments, and you guys will notice that I kind of go back and forth. I'm an artist. I'm a fine artist, so I'm always thinking in terms of art terms, I guess, like installments or installations, I'll call them sometimes. It feels like an installment, you know, like an investment or something, but it's an episode. And there will be a future episode of the Bailey Minute where you can see me trying all these outfits on. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time. I'm Brooke. Bye-bye.